Once again, good morning, class. For today, for this morning session, our topic is about early forms of prison discipline. Okay? In this particular discussion, pag-aralan natin kung ano ba yung mga iba't ibang uri ng pagdisiplina inside the prison noong unang panahon. Okay? I have here a question. What do you think are the early forms of prison discipline? Ano sa tingin nyo ang iba't ibang uri ng prison discipline? Okay, ito ay pagdisiplina ng mga prisoner inside the prison facility. Okay? Okay, we have here number one, hard labor, productive works. So, nung una, yung mga prisoners ay pinapatrabaho prison guards or prison officers or officials. So, pinapatrabaho nila as a form of discipline. Para madisiplina yung mga prisoners, ang ginagawa ay pinapatrabaho. Okay? Okay naman siya kasi it a productive works eh, may ginagawa. And again, it is a form of discipline. Okay, we have number two, deprivation. So from the word deprivation, hindi binibigyan siya ng mga, like for example, mga gamit, newspaper or anything na gusto ng prisoners. Deprivation of everything except, of course, the essentials of existence like food, water. So, yun lang ang binibigay. At the rest, hindi na binibigay. Deprivation. Okay? Then, the third one, we have monotony. Giving the same food that is off diet. Okay? Palagi na lang yung kanilang pagkain, same. Or requiring prisoners to perform boring daily routine. So, yan. It's either giving same food or requiring a prisoner to a boring routine, daily routine. Monotony. A form of prison discipline. And we have uniformity. Okay, the fault of one is the fault of all. So, they treat prisoners alike. So, kung may kasalanan yung isa, lahat ng grupo ay kasalanan din. Okay? So, kung may nagkasalaman sa kanila, in a group, may nagkasala, yung grupo ang pinaparusahan. Okay? Uniformity is a form of prison discipline noong unang panahon. At kahit ngayon ay ina-adapt pa rin ito, pinapractice pa rin ito, yung tinatawag na uniformity. Okay? And usually yung mga trainings ninyo about mga reception rights or whatever trainings, do you have militaristic training? Practice pa rin yung tinatawag na fault of one is the fault of all. Diba? Kahit isa lang yung nagkasala, lahat ng membro na ay paparusahan. Okay? Uniformity ang tawag dyan. That is not actually for punishment purposes but to discipline the individual, the prisoner. Okay? This is not a punishment but to discipline. Not para hindi naman ulit masama na ginawa ng prisoner. Okay, so we have mass movement, no? Mass living in cell blocks, mass eating, mass recreation, mass bathing. So lahat pag sila ay naligo, lahat sabayan, no? Sabay magkumain, sabay ligo at iba pa. Lahat sabay. Mass movement. Prison discipline din yan. Kahit ngayon, ina-apply pa rin yung mass. No? Usually sa militaristic training, mass movement ina-apply yan as a form of discipline. Dapat sabay-sabay. Yan. We have degradation, uttering insulting words or languages on the part of prison staff to the prisoners to degrade or break the confidence of the prisoners. Okay, parang saywar, di ba? Ini-insult to what? Break the confidence. Yan. At ini the prison staff embarrass the prisoner at ini-degrade. Yan. Degradation. We have corporal punishment, brutal punishment, or imprisonment. Like torture to intimidate a delinquent inmate. So, anong purpose ng itong corporal punishment? Eh, para takutin yung prisoner para hindi na gagawa ng masama or hindi na lalabag sa prison rules. Okay. And isolation, confinement, ano naman to? Of course, ina-isolate, inukulong yung prisoner, no? Mag-isa lang siya. Communication, walang news, also known as the lone wolf. Okay? Isolation or solitary confinement. So mag-isa lang siya sa silda, walang kausap. Okay? AKA the lone wolf. So it is not a punishment, but a discipline, a form of discipline. Okay, so that's all in this particular discussion. Pinag-usapan natin yung iba't ibang uri ng prison discipline. Okay?